Thank you. I'm here with two of the greatest friends of Israel, and they're also my personal friends, Senator Lindsey Graham and Ambassador David Friedman. Senator, this is not your first time in the Golan Heights, but I think every time you come here, you can appreciate the strategic importance of Israel being on the Golan Heights and the fact that we're creating here new life, green life, future, which is very different, obviously, from what existed before. I think the most important observation that I'd make is that the Golan has always been part of Israel from the earliest days of our history, and it's certainly been the part of the state of Israel since 1967 and more recently since 1981. The Golan is part of Israel. The Golan must stay part of Israel forever. And I think it's very important that the international community recognize this fact and accept it, and most especially our great friend, the United States of America. I want to thank you for your unbelievable support. I don't think the citizens of Israel know everything that I know about the work you've done over successive administrations. We have no greater friend, and we appreciate it. So thank you, friend, and welcome, friend.
Thank you very much. Well,
can you face more?
Face this way?
Thank you. Yeah, thank you very much.
Okay. I come here as a United States Senator from the state of South Carolina. I come here as an American. I come here to try to figure out what's best for America. What's best for America is for a safe, secure, and prosperous Israel. Why? Common values, common enemies, and from a military point of view, the best friend the United States could possibly ever have in a troubled region. I cannot tell you how much intelligence is given to the United States from our friends in Israel that protect the American homeland. So if you believe as I do, the state of Israel is a strategic partner to the United States, and its survival and its prosperity and security is relevant to American national security, you would come here. The Golan. For decades, this was one of the more peaceful parts of the border that Israel has to police. Not so much now. So I've got a simple message. I will go back to the United States Senate, working with Senator Cruz. I will start an effort to recognize the Golan as part of the state of Israel, now and forever, because to give this territory up would be a strategic nightmare for the state of Israel. And who would you give it to? That's Syria. It is a mess. My heart breaks for the Syrian people. You're not helping the Syrian people by putting Israel at extreme risk. There is no construct I can imagine now or any time in the future for the state of Israel to give the Golan up. And I want people who start wars and dismember the neighborhood to be punished. Israel occupied this territory by fighting for its survival. This territory was taken by military force because it was used as a launching point to attack the state of Israel. This territory has a rich Jewish history. Strategically, I am standing on one of the most important pieces of ground in the state of Israel. And who would you give it back to? You're going to give it to Assad? I think not. Might as well give it to Iran. You're going to give it to Russia? I think not. So the idea of this territory going to somebody else is off the table. And I do believe there's bipartisan support in the Congress to recognize the Golan Heights as part of the state of Israel for a lot of reasons. In the State Department, there's a map, and this part, the Golan, is labeled as disputed territory. My goal is to try to persuade the administration to change that designation, that it's not disputed. The Golan is not in dispute. The Golan is in the hands of Israel and always remain in the hands of Israel.
I agree.
So, we will be talking to President Trump when I get back about the necessity of recognizing the Golan as part of Israel, that it is inconceivable that Israel could ever give it to anyone, given the threats Israel faces. And I'll tell the president there's unity here. There's not one political party of note in Israel that would come out with a different conclusion. So if you're looking for common ground politically in Israel, it would be the Golan. If you're looking for strategic ground to keep Israel safe and secure, it would be the Golan. If you're looking for to send a message to the world about what happens if you attack Israel, it would be giving the Golan to Israel. And I want everyone to know, those who wish to destroy Israel, and they're growing in number, the more you do to harm this state, the more America will do to protect this state. Because if Israel falls, we're next.
Thank you. David, do you want to say anything?
I could not agree more with Senator Graham, and I thank you, as always, for your incredible leadership on this issue. Thank you, Senator.
Thank you.